we should be ready to rock and roll. The Beavers will be starting on vault, and University of Washington will start on bars.
That was a fun vault highlight video. I wonder if they're, that's new, they might be doing that for each event.
Well, and I have to say, that we get a look at the Leos, they're beautiful. They're absolutely beautiful. It's fun to see all the new designs and what you can do with black and orange.
Uh-huh. Yeah, those are quite different. I'm trying to recall if Oregon State has ever had like a more open back style. Those are very pretty. I love all the sparkles as well.
And I know that you can attest to this too, Stephanie. As a former gymnast, it's so fun and exciting to don a new Leo. And you just—it makes you just—you're so proud, but you're also so excited, and it just kind of adds to the hype and to your adrenaline, which is great for our first rotation, which is vault. Leading off will be Lauren Letch, followed by Sydney Gonzalez, and here we go.
So freshman Lauren Letch getting ready for her Yurchenko full. Michael Chaplin did tell us that she's training a 1.5. But ooh, there's a beautiful Yurchenko full today. And that was a great landing. Those are the details that the Beavs are looking for as we head further into season here. That was just a very, very solid start.
Absolutely. The highest score that Lauren can get on this is a 9.95. That's what this Yurchenko layout full is valued at. And boy, it's going to be close. And it's just a tiny,
little off balance. Yes. Like just didn't show that complete control of the landing that the judges are looking for. But her feet didn't really move either. So should be a solid start. And over on bars for UW, this is Dia Moody. And Dia is another freshman. She's from Frisco, Texas. Getting ready for her dismount. Nice roll in and a step landing.
Also a strong start for Washington. Back over to vault. This is Sydney Gonzalez. She's scored a 9.85 twice this year. Her vault's very unique. She does the Yurchenko approach, which is the round-off entry. But if you watch carefully, she will do a Yurchenko half on, and then she does another half twist, pike salto off the vault, and it is worth a 10.0. And other than the hop on the landing, that was a solid vault. Would love to see her get a little bit more height, a little bit more explosion off that, but the type of vault doesn't lead to a lot of a really, really big height because you're twisting on and off of the table. Another look at it. And just a little hop in the landing. Great vault for Sydney. Getting ready for bars for the Gym Dogs will be Brenna Brooks. And Brenna is a senior from Allen, Texas. And between the Oregon State Leos and the Gym Dogs Leos, we got a lot of sparkles.
I really like the Gym Dog Leos as well.
We got a lot of sparkles going on. They're very pretty.
Yeah, I like the Washington.
Yeah, that's a fun
glitter across the back.
They're getting awfully creative. They didn't have anything like this one when I was competing. All right, this is Brenna Brooks. Nice handstand. Judges are always looking for that little form deduction there. Very small though. And another small leg separation, but she really is hitting her handstands well. Maybe a little short on that one. Giant full pirouette into an immediate double flyaway. Nice height, and it looks like a stuck landing. Couldn't quite see her feet when she landed, but another solid routine.
Over on vault is fifth year Caitlin Yanis. And another Yurchenko full and just a small scooch. Caitlin has so much power. And often, I've noticed that she'll have the power but not quite control the landing. And that was a very solid vault from Caitlin with just the small scooch back on the landing. Yeah, I mean, so Caitlin's season high on vault is a 9.875, and I'm thinking that she'll be close to that mark for that vault. Back over on bars for the Gym Dogs, Taylor Russin, the sophomore from Redwood City, California, be getting ready to compete.
And interesting, she scored a 9.725 exactly each of the three meets that they've competed in. So I know she's hoping to break into that 9.8 range, but it's unusual to get the exact same score.
Talk about consistency.
I know, three meets in a row.
As I said, Taylor's a sophomore. Gym Dogs have a fairly young team this year, a lot of underclassmen getting some great competition experience. Opening up with and she missed her straddle Jaeger, just too far away from the bar. So that will be a 5-10 deduction, and the Gym Dogs will be looking to drop Taylor's score. And remember, it's 6 gymnasts up with 5 of the routines counting. So now the pressure is on for Taylor's teammates. But the good news for UW is that they are competing 6 athletes up on bars this meet. I believe earlier in the season they only put 5 up. And so in that situation, everyone has to hit. I mean, again, we're in that situation here because of the fall. The teammates have to hit, but there is that option for the Gym Dogs to not count Taylor's score.
Yeah, it's nice to have that breather to know that you've got 6 really strong routines up, and because mistakes happen.
And just want to say that Beaver Nation is such a supportive fan base. The fans were clapping for Taylor as she got back up on the bar. Giant pull into a double tuck, and nice stick to finish that tune up for Taylor.
Maddie has been on fire the last two meets, 9.925 and a 9.9. Her vault is a 1.5. If she sticks, it's worth a 10. Oh, and just a small hop there. Such a powerful gymnast. On the replay, we'll get to see I want you to pay attention to the distance that she gets. It's really remarkable. One more look at it. It's the Yurchenko, 1.5 twist blind landing, and look how far away she is from the table. Just a small hop on the landing. And over on bars, we'll get our look here at Skylar Killowellham. She is UW's only all-arounder and has been extremely consistent on this event. She's gotten 2.99s this season. And she's only a sophomore.
And she also competed all around last year as a freshman. So a very strong gymnast for the Gym Dogs.
Nice hop change to a piked Jaeger. Just beautiful form. Her legs are glued together. Nice handstand, giant blind. Front giant half pirouette. This combination gives her the bonus she needs to start from a 10.0. It's a really nice, clean routine from Skylar.
Over on vault for the Beavs, this is Carly Chavez, the freshman from Clovis, California. And last weekend, Carly competed a 1.5. Let's see see if she'll do it again. There's that 1.5 going for the 10.0 start value. Looked like she was a little bit lower on that landing, kind of a pretty deep lead in than what the judges are looking for, as well as that hop. So there will be some deductions for Carly's balls, but out of that 10.0.
Interestingly, Carly was the leadoff, and she's moved into this number 5 slot, which is a pretty big deal. Her score did boost up to a 9.8 last season. Here's a quick look at our scores. So far, nice and solid.
Over on bars for the Gym Dogs, this is fifth year Geneva Thompson. Geneva is a local Pacific Northwest athlete from Gwalit, Washington. Mounting up to the high bar. Looks like her first handstand might have been a wee bit short there. Into a nice high straddled Jaeger. Another solid handstand. Overshoot to handstand. Headed up to the high bar. A little bit hard to tell from this angle, but that final handstand may have been short. Into
wow.
a floaty, nice double layout.
That was beautiful.
That was a great routine for Geneva. And her season high on bars is a 9.875. So I think with that routine, she will be right up in that range.
And here's Jade's first of her 4 events tonight. She's ranked 8th in the nation on vault. And she does this double full, Yurchenko double full that is so effortless looking, you almost forget that she does 2 twists.
Absolutely. And she like finished the twist early enough. I mean, I thought maybe she was going to stick that one and just drop it in perfectly.
One more look at it. Look at the height. There's 2 twists and just the hop on the landing. Her season high is a 9.95. I don't think she'll get that tonight with that hop. There's another look at the scores. Oh, and we already see a 9.9 flashed for her.
That was quick.
That was very quick.
Wow. Turn that around.
And over on bars, anchoring the Gym Dogs, this is Morgan Bowles. Morgan is a junior from Las Vegas, Nevada. Nice giant full pirouette to a ginger. Or sorry, not a ginger, that's a delcha.
Yeah.
We don't see those very often. Running up for her double layout. Oh, a little low on that. She was able to hang on to it with a small hop.
On vault for the bees, this is Caitlin Garcia in exhibition. A solid Yurchenko full. So as in the exhibition spot, Caitlin's score will not count towards the Beavers' total, but a great opportunity for Caitlin to get experience out on the competition floor and for the coaches to test the depth of their lineup. And I'd say, you know, outside of the, in previous years, that is a vault that definitely would have been in the Beavers lineup.
Absolutely.
So definitely speaks to the improvements the Beavs have made on the vault that Caitlin is in that exhibition spot.
Yeah, and getting a 9.8 as an exhibitionist,
that's
a solid score. I thought we were going to have an exhibition on bars, but I don't think we are.
And we will have one more gymnast forming an exhibition for the Beavs. It'll be Caitlin Poylan.
Also Another Yurchenko layout full for Caitlin. Great experience for both Caitlins.
Yeah, two solid Yurchenko fulls in exhibition. That's great for the Beavs.
When she is in tears of joy, that must have been a very momentous vault for her. One more look at it. We'll see 1965 and 198. And taking a look at the team scores, we're only up by 1/10 right now is the difference between the Beavers and Washington. They're going to look to expand that lead.
So we'll be moving into the second rotation here any minute. While we wait, chat a little bit about the coaching staff for both teams. So Tanya Chaplin is going into her 25th season at Oregon State alongside her husband, Michael Chaplin. And Tanya formerly competed at UCLA, where she was a six-time All-American. And looks like we are getting started on vaults.
And this is Ashley Blum. Yurchenko layout full. Small hop on the landing. Pretty solid start for the Gym Dogs. And over on bars, this is Colette Yamaoka. She's a fifth year student from Chandler, Arizona. She's a bar specialist. This is her only event for today.
Oh, just a note, Colette is from Hollister, California.
My apologies. Beautiful. So far, Colette is looking very, very nice. She's coming back from an injury that kept her out all of last year, but has been really consistent the last couple of meets for the Beavers. Looking to break into the 9-8 barrier.
For the Gym Dogs, Brenna Brooks is competing. And she just performed a Yurchenko hack twist. And we'll circle back later to take a look at Brenna's vault. Brenna is another athlete who is returning from injury last year. This is freshman Carly Beeman. This will be her only event tonight. Line change into a straddled Jaeger. That was definitely a close one. Saw Heather kind of wince next to me, so the judges will be taking a deduction there. Into a nice hot salt pull down to the low bar. Like a nice high bar handstand into a stalder and a double tuck dismount. Slight switch on the dismount. Carly's season and career high on bars is a 9.85. So with the close Jaeger, she will not be meeting that score tonight. Back over on vault, this is all-arounder Skylar Killa Wilhelm. A solid Yurchenko full.
Great job for Skylar. We could take one more look at it. She's improved. Oh, We won't get to see it one more time, but that's all right. She has improved every meet, though, on this event. We'll be able to get scores to you later, though, too. We'll be moving over to bars here momentarily to get a look at Maddie Dagan.
I have to say, so far, the judges are moving very quickly this meet.
They are, which is great. That means that they're in alignment. Mm-hmm. If there's usually a holdup, it's because their start values don't match up or they're too far apart. It's not the case today. Maddie's career high is in 9.9.
Just last weekend.
Yes. She has improved her bar routine, adding that Takacha fin. So she now starts from a 10.0. Toe to handstand, very nicely done. Giant full pirouette, immediate double tuck, and a stuck landing. From our angle, she looked a little bit close to the high bar, but it wasn't the best angle to really judge that. That was a really nice routine.
That time it was me flinching a little bit. Looked a little close to the high bar, like Heather said.
This is Lana Navarro.
Lana is a freshman for the Gym Dogs who has really stepped up recently for the University of Washington. Taking another look at her vault. That was a very nice Euro-Tinko 1.5. Looks like she could have absorbed that landing a little bit more.
Mm-hmm.
Like, oh, there's the ground and a small hop, but very nice. And again, that 10.0 start value with the 1.5 flip. Over on bars, this is junior Kayla Bird. Looks like she was short on that high bar handstand, but a very nice overshoot into immediate scalder. Getting ready for her Takacha here. Now, Kayla's Takacha is always very high, but just doesn't quite turn over enough.
I think she turned over a little bit more today. That looked better than the last time we saw her.
And a small speech on the dismount, but a solid routine for Kayla. Another look at her dismount there.
Over on vault for the Gym Dogs, this is Geneva Thompson. She has scored a 9.95 at this season. She's a very powerful vaulter.
And she's very good at dropping that landing in and coming up with the stick.
Oh, and
just
she did it again.
That.
You know, it's going to be hard to find any deduction in that. That's
mm-hmm.
worth a 9.95. So really, it's like getting a perfect 10 because she can't get any higher than that. And one more look at it. Look at the height, the flare out, and perfect landing.
I mean, that might be the first event Jade doesn't come away with the title.
And she did it again. Let's see, I see an, oh, no, 9.9 from one
five?
And a 9.95 from another. Only a quarter tenth away from a perfect score for her. And over on bars for the Beavers, this is Phoebe Yakuchik. Phoebe has such a unique bar routine. A little bit short on that handstand, but watch this. Blind change, this beautiful Maloney, and then back up to the high bar, and then in bar Ginger, very difficult. Winding up for her dismount, a radiant double front, blind landing. Just a tiny scooch with her foot on that landing. Very, very good. One more look at that dismount, and her foot just slid back just a hair.
another beautiful vault for the Gym Dogs.
If you can't put up a 10-0 start value, you've got to do a vault like this.
Definitely.
Wow.
We see freshman Jay Carey getting ready for her bar routine. As we said earlier, she's coming off of that perfect 10 from last weekend, and she is actually ranked number one in the nation on bars at this point in the season.
See if she can do it again.
Opening with a Maloney to immediate pack full. She just floats, makes it look so easy. Back up to the high bar with the Maloney half. And getting ready for her dismount will be a full in.
And another stuff.
The stick! Wow.
She does these very difficult
skills
and makes it look like it's nothing. I wouldn't be surprised if she got another 10. It was just beautiful.
What would you take for a deduction, Heather?
So you could pick it apart, and in slow motion, you could see her legs come apart slightly on her dismount. But in real time and from the side, you often don't see those things as a judge. So it really depends on their angle, what they saw.
Right. We didn't have the best angle here for her handstands, and the judges are in a prime spot to see whether or not they hit that perfect handstand. But I see
and
Gill getting to their feet.
A 995 I see from one judge. And,
975.
There it is.
Wow.
Oh. And with that score, I would be surprised if she dropped out of the number one ranking.
I was just going to say, I think she will hold her number one rank this week.
And I know that she is so humble and just, she's blown away, I think, by just how everything is going this year. And it's just so fun to hear her talk. She's so kind.
And in exhibition, this is Jenna Domingo. We'll see Jenna later today on the theme lineup. Struggled a little bit there with her overshoot.
She is hanging in there.
And a double tuck dismount. Bit of form break there on Jenna's line change, and then the hop on the landing. You see Coach Michael Chaplin giving Jenna a high five there. Michael recently switched to coaching bars. In the past, he was always the vault and floor coach, but with Brian Rashilla in his second season here at Oregon State, Brian has been focusing on vaults, putting Michael on bars, and the Bees did struggle last year on bars, definitely their weaker events, but as Heather said, they've made some significant improvements since then.
Absolutely. We're going to get a look at one more exhibition performance. And there you have it, Natalie Briones. I believe this is the first time we've seen Natalie this year.
Oh, nice eagle grip.
Beautiful eagle grip. So there's a Higgins into a straddled Jaeger. Nice pack salto. Maybe a little short on that handstand. Hard to see from this angle. Winding up for a double layout. And a little short, but she has the skills.
Yeah, she'll be looking to break into that lineup.
Just needs to get them a little bit more consistent, but huge potential there. One more look at her double layout. She lets go just a tiny bit early.
Has to fake it down there. But she knew that she needed to pike it down in order to make it to her feet.
And here's a look at the scores. Beavers have increased their lead by a little bit more, 98-3-5 to 98-1-7-5.
But the Gym Dogs are right in the competition.
Absolutely. A lot can happen on Beamon floor. We're only halfway there.
And here is sophomore Skylar Killa-Wilhelm leading off for the Gym Dogs. And floor has been UW's weakest event this season. So they will be looking for clean tumbling and expressive dance. Skylar opening her floor routine with a front double twist. Struggled a little bit with the landing there, low as well as the sidestep. Skylar's season high on the floor is a 9.85. So with the landing on her first pass, probably won't be needing that much. Second tumbling pass, 1.5 punch front layout. Nice and clean there. And we're seeing more and more athletes do just the two tumbling passes. So if the gymnast can meet the required difficulty, there's nothing in the rules that says they have to do three tumbling passes. So if they have two passes that are difficult enough and meet all the requirements, then they will opt to just go with the two passes.
And over on beam, this is Lauren Letch. Lauren Letch has been such a strong freshman presence already, scoring a 9.85 last weekend on this event. Beautiful front aerial to back handspring for her acrobatic series. On bars, beam, and floor, the girls start at a 9.4, and then they have to create enough bonus to start from a 10.0. So that's where the different combinations that you see are so important to achieve that bonus enough to start from a 10.0. That's a beautiful example. Ariel into her dismount. A little bit hesitant, but she pulled that off.
Yeah, Lauren has been such a strong freshman for the Bees. And I really do feel in other freshman classes, you know, we would be talking about her a lot more because beautiful gymnast, you know, those ring jumps, some unique skills that she performs, and so graceful.
She is very graceful, very beautiful to watch. Michael Chaplin says she is one to watch, absolutely. Over on floor, for the Gym Dogs, this is Lana Navarro. She has been inconsistent on floor this year, but when she hits, she is phenomenal. She's earned a 9.875 two times. She's also fallen two times, so. Lana's opening run, really nice high double tuck, great landing. Ooh, she almost stepped out of bounds. She knew where she was though. Round off 1.5 to front layout. Just a tiny leg separation. Other than that, very nice. didn't have enough gas in the tank. Ending with a double pike. Very difficult last pass.
Back over on beam. Oh, quick look at that last pass, but we will hop over to Jenna's beamer team. And Jenna has been having a very strong season on beam. Beautiful acro series there with a front aerial to back pike. More unique acro series. See a lot of backhands and back layouts, so that acro series really helps her stand out to the judges. Pretty full turn there, required full turn element, showing off her flexibility down on the beam.
And Jenna's the only other OSU gymnast to have earned a title because she tied for first with Jade,
right,
of course.
With a 9.925 earlier in the season.
Very uncharacteristic.
Yes. Very unusual fall there from Jenna.
And on a leap series as well, that we don't see that very often. I think her shoulders just got away from her on that jump.
So now the back half of the beam lineup has the pressure on to pull out those three hit routines. But this is the type of scenario that you train for in the gym, do all the different pressure sets, so I'm sure that the Beeves are prepared for this.
Absolutely. Over on floor.
This is Ashley Blum. Ashley is a freshman from Big Harbor, Washington. First tumbling pass, front tuck into a double tuck. Had her front foot there just take a bit of a stutter step. Didn't look like she needed it. So those are the little kind of details that the gymdogs will be looking to dial in as we make our way through the competition season. For her second tumbling pass here. Double pike for Mashley. A little bit of flexed feet and legs apart in that double pike. As we said before, somewhat depends on the angle that the judges are at, whether or not they'll be able to see that leg separation. And a quick replay of that double pike.
Over on beam, Sydney Gonzalez. Sydney's a sophomore in Newport Beach, California. Nice acro series. And with Jenna's fall, the Beavers have to be solid. Can't afford any more mistakes. So far, Sydney looks beautiful. She was the only freshman last year to compete in all 10 meets. And she has earned a 9.9 on this event.
I have to say, those new Beaver Leos, they look even more sparkly in person than on the screen.
Getting ready for her dismount. She's an aerial to a back full. Great job getting the Beavers back on track. One more. more. Look at that dismount. Just the tiniest of hops. And over on floor, it's Geneva Thompson. Now, Geneva fell in the first three meets of the season.
Yeah, she's been struggling on floor this season.
But she did rebound last weekend with a 9-7. So I know she's hoping to just continue to improve. And with Kennedy Davis out of the lineup, they need her more than ever. A whip to a double tuck. Oh, a little bit low, but she was able to hang on to it.
And I think she's been experimenting with some different tumbling passes as well. Last weekend she did a front double twist.
Switch ring, front leg just a tiny bit low, showing that 180 split. You can tell she loves to perform though. Fun, high energy routine. Talking to herself, as gymnasts often do. Front Rudy. And Geneva Thompson.
And getting ready for the bees will be Maddie Dagan.
Fun ending.
And Maddie was a 2021 Pac-12 First Team Award winner. This season, she hasn't quite nailed that junior team that we've come to expect from Maddie, with a season high of 9.825 versus her career high of 9.925. So still looking for that really dialed in junior team from Maddie. Pretty leap series there for Maddie with the switch leap to switch off, followed by a beat jump. Dismount there with a side aerial to a stacked full twist. I like how she like stuck it and then just clicked her heels together. It's just, did you make sure you saw that, judges? Really look at that dismount there. Nicely done from Maddie. And the judges are conferencing about Geneva's routine, so we might have a little bit of a wait here.
So they're either conferencing about the start value, or if their scores are too far apart, they're required to come together and figure out. They just compare notes and say, I took this, I took that. And somewhere somebody either comes up or somebody comes down, and they have to narrow that gap. Unfortunately, that means that Amara Cunningham, who's getting ready to go on floor, has to wait, which can be a little rattling.
Yeah, and the thing about the sport of gymnastics is at the end of the day, it's really the scores that matter. So the rankings for the teams aren't based off of wins and losses. It's based on the scores. And so the NQS, or the National Qualifying Score, is calculated each week, and the rankings are based off of that. And so the way that that works is it's the top six scores for a team, and that must include three away meets. And then the highest score is dropped, and the remaining five scores are averaged. And so that formula tries to somewhat weigh for what can be a factor in home scoring by forcing the inclusion of those away meets. And then also, if you have some really big scores, having to drop the highest scores. And so, but at this point in the season, it's interesting because obviously you need to have at least 6 meets in order to do that calculation. So right now in season, the rankings are based purely on the average score. And that's for the first 7 weeks of the season.
This sets up as a very big game in the Pac-12.
And a perfect delivery. Touchdown.
Double tuck. Solid landing there. Makes that tumbling pass look easy. Mara is getting her teammates into her routine. You can see them supporting and dancing her with her on the sidelines. Low chest on that landing there. So that'll be a deduction. Fun routine from Mara, but not her usual super solid landing, that low chest on her double pike.
Over on beam, Jade Carey. She's ranked 6th in the nation on this event. Tiny, tiny balance check. Those full turns are required. Some gymnasts love them, some hate them. It's often the Achilles heel. And she did make a mistake on that front aerial, but she has a back handspring layout. So she won't get the connection bonus, but she will get the required series, which is worth 2/10.
Now, does she need that connection bonus, Heather?
It's a great question. I don't know. Without adding up all of her bonus, wouldn't be able to tell you right away. But another stuck landing, and Jade is human, so mistakes are going to happen. And if they're going to happen on any event, it's usually beam.
Yes.
Another look at her dismount. That was perfect.
And also, we're saying mistakes, but it's just a balance check.
I know. I mean, they're just, it's so
it's just that
small.
She's been so perfect.
So small. Anchoring for the Gym Dogs will be Issa Weitz. She was going to compete as an exhibition, but when Kennedy Davis came out of the lineup today, Issa stepped in, which is what the girls are prepared to do.
And it's interesting, sometimes when there's a lineup like teams like that, really dependent on the athlete and the lineup, whether the judges will decide to slot her in the anchor position, like Jen Llewellyn did here, or if they'll end up being the leadoff or somewhere in the middle. Looks like they decided to keep the normal order and have her bring you dead home on floor.
his first tumbling pass. Round off to a double pike. Really beautiful. And if it looked different, it's because she didn't do a back handspring, which you don't have to do, but it is unusual. Second tumbling pass, round off back 1.5 to a front layout. Really solid. Playing to the crowd. Which I do love about Oregon State crowd. They just love good gymnastics. So they appreciate and will play along with all of the gymnasts. That is a very interesting view.
Yeah, speaking of the Oregon State crowd, being Super Bowl Sunday, I have to say there's a lot of people here.
I'm impressed. Last tumbling pass. Round off, double tuck, and it she almost stuck that just perfectly. Great anchor spot for her. And they needed it. One more look at that last pass. And then over on beam, this is Caitlin Yanish. We're used to seeing her, but not on this event. This is an exhibition performance for the Beavers.
Yeah, she has done beam here and there, really incomplete, not very often. That was pretty unique after a series there from Caitlin.
We're so used to seeing, you know, the power that she has on vault and on floor. And she's still powerful on this event. She has to control that power now. And she's doing a really nice job.
And Caitlin is an athlete who chose to use her extra year of eligibility from COVID to come back for another season for the Beavers.
And I know they're so grateful she did. She's such a strong member of this team. And that will do it for the third rotation. We'll get you some scores here pretty soon. And the Beavers have really increased their lead to the 147.6 to 147.075. That is Jade's lowest score of the season with a 9.875, which
below
is 99. Still mind-boggling to me. But they will be heading into a very strong event.
Yeah, the Beavs are currently ranked number 7 in the nation on floor. And last weekend, they came away with a big 49.5.
Final rotation about to get underway. Assistant Coach Brian talking to Sydney Gonzalez, who will be starting the Beavers off.
So headed into floor, you certainly have the lead. But with that, like you said, really at the end of the day, it's the score that UW is looking for to improve their ranking. And so the meet is by no means over for the Gym Dogs. They'll be looking to put up 6 for 6, see a strong beam performance.
Not sure what the holdup is here.
Last minute advice there to Sydney Gonzalez. Carey's numerous accomplishments are her Pac-12 weekly awards. So
yes.
She's come away with Gymnast of the Week, I believe, twice, as well as Freshman of the Week twice. Also, Maddie Dagan last weekend was the Pac-12
Coach's
selection.
Yes.
So really exciting to see the Beavers back winning those Pac-12 weekly selection awards.
Especially considering how strong the Pac-12
exactly.
is.
Exactly. Well, I guess this meet has been going so quickly that
I know.
Just felt there was people just maybe didn't want it to end yet. Just have a little delay in here.
We should be starting over on beam with Brenna Brooks. There we go. Okay. This is Brenna Brooks. As I mentioned before, Brenna's a senior from Allen, Texas. She missed last season due to injuries.
Nice kick over front to back handspring from Brenna.
And I just found out the holdup was a last minute change in the lineup for Washington. Taylor Russell will not be performing as scheduled. And instead, Lauren Thomas will be taking her place. So far, Brenna looks beautiful on this event. Very solid. Front aerial. Nice stag jump into a gainer full. Fun and unique combination for her dismount. Sydney's anxious to get going here. She's been ready for a while. Sydney's very, very clean on this event. She has two tumbling passes. She opens with a front layout, full to a front layout. Sydney's a sophomore majoring in business and marketing. Sydney's second and final tumbling pass, double pipe, a little bit low with her chest, but great landing with her feet. We'll see what the judges do with that. She had a strong start for the Beavers, though, on floor. Another look at her beautiful second leap series.
Getting some last minute words of encouragement is Leah Moody. One she'll get that connection with the split jump or not.
It's always a little iffy whether the judges are would give that to her or not, but her arms didn't stop moving, so I'd be inclined to say they will.
And a nice dismount with side aerial to back rail full. Hopping over to floor, Junior Kayla Bird. And Kayla Bird is one of the student athletes in the Honors College, where she's studying human development and family science. She has such a pretty straddle jump out of that first tumbling pass. Saw a Rudy into a sky-high straddle jump.
And if your shoulders aren't perfectly square going into that, you can send that completely wonky. And she did a beautiful job with it.
Yeah, really nice control. Now, sometimes here on her 2.5 twist, the landing, she can end up a little bit of a significant sidestep. So we'll see how that 2.5 twist goes today. Solid. I mean, still a deduction on the landing and legs crossing over in the twist, but a nice routine from Kayla.
One more look at that. You can see the leg cross and just the not solid landing. Not a major deduction, but still every tenth counts. Over on beam for the Gym Dogs, this is Lana Navarro. She's only competed on beam twice this season, but one was a 9.9 and the other was a 9.825.
Yeah, to come out and break into the lineup with a 9.9, that is quite impressive.
Absolutely. Lana's acro series here. Backhand spring, layout, step out. And unfortunately, that means University of Washington will have to count a fall. Switch side, little balance check there. Nice full turn. Getting ready for her dismount. Round off. Double full. Didn't quite complete the twist on that. It was interesting because I wasn't sure what she was doing there for a moment because it was a very slow twist. And over on floor, this is Lauren Letch. Lauren has this just beautiful balance between power and grace. She scored a 9.9 against UCLA earlier in the year. She's another gymnast that only does two tumbling passes. But they're beautiful. She opens to 1.5 to a front layout full. Gorgeous. Dances right out of it. No deduction. Beautiful leap series into full turn there. Getting ready for her final tumbling pass. She has a huge double pike. Gorgeous. This should score very well.
That was a beautiful routine. The teammates are excited about it.
Absolutely, rightfully so. One more look at that double pike, sky high, beautiful and controlled landing.
And here comes senior Morgan Bowles. I hear some cheers from Gill.
A 995 from one judge and a 99 from another.
Exciting.
A new career high for Lauren.
A nice aerial to aerial, side aerial to side aerial.
Unusual connection.
Definitely do not see that every day.
Wow.
And a pretty full turn, showing her complete control. Jump to Wolf Bowl for Morgan's League Series. Oh no. Oh, shoot.
It looked like her legs just buckled under her.
Yeah, it looked like she had it. Yeah, it was right there, and then.
That's unfortunate.
Oh, that'll be a rough beam score for the gym dogs.
Just one more look here. Let's see if we can see what happened. Oh, yeah.
I mean, she was a little far back and then just like didn't manage to take that step quick enough to stay on her feet. And here's senior Maddie Dagan. She's been nicely set up by freshman Lauren Lech, so we'll be looking for a big score from the back half of the Beaver lineup.
She's definitely capable of it.
Oh. Nice front double twist for Maddie. Really nice control on the landing there. Yeah, the front double twists, you know, don't look quite as impressive, say, as the full ins or the really high double pikes, but that is a very difficult opening tumbling toss. And a pretty front layout to front layout full, and Maddie danced out of there nicely. Taking a breather there before her final tumbling pass. Double pike. And another great routine for the Beaks.
She didn't have a perfectly controlled landing on that last pass, but I don't see anything else wrong with that routine. It was just beautiful.
Look at that last tumbling pass. Yeah, kind of a large scooch back. Not a full on step, but like not quite as much control as we'd like to ideally see.
Over on beam.
This is Lauren Thomas, a sophomore from Loveland, Colorado. And this has been the lineup change. So Lauren was not originally scheduled to compete on beam, but got called step up. And she will be looking to turn things around for the gym dogs on beam.
Absolutely.
Kick over front to backhands little bit of a bounce check, but always nice to get that acro series out of the way. Full turn. And I heard some cheering from the crowd. I imagine that Maddie got a high floor score.
I see a 9.925.
Oh, wow. Yeah, that can always be a bit of an element when you're on beam and the crowd erupts in cheers, but I'm sure Lauren is focused in, probably didn't even hear it.
Well, that'll be interesting to see what the judges do with that leap series, because she did not connect the two together, which is a special requirement worth 0.2.
On that 1.5 twist dismount there. So Lauren took a step backwards versus step forwards. And step backwards didn't have quite enough rotation. Would really, if she's going to take a step, you know, more ideal to be stepping forwards, showing that you've got enough rotation and flip to make it around.
Here's Caitlin Yanish. Season high, 9.9 last weekend. She has one of the most beautiful double layouts in the country. Oh, and she did it! She's been training that. Wasn't sure she was going to do it. It's a double layout where she splits her legs in the middle of it, which makes it infinitely harder. And she did it like it was nothing. What a fun addition for Caitlin. And a front layout full to a front layout. Caitlin's on fire.
Hey, if you can get the landing on this last pass. And that split double layout has been recently made famous by Caitlin Ohashi from UCLA with her
Vile
for a team, but very fun to see that performed by Caitlin.
And all Caitlin has to do is nail her double tuck. And look at the height that she gets. So high.
Yeah.
Oh, and she did it. Judges are going to find that it's going to be hard to take anything on that. That was spectacular. And the beavers are on their feet, out on the floor, and the fans are on their feet as well. One more look at that double tuck. Gorgeous.
Caitlin's career high is a 9.975, so she can pull out those big scores, and that routine would certainly be one of them.
And over on beam for University of Washington, their anchor, this is Skylar Kilhoe-Wellham. She scored a 9.9 or better the first three meets. Oh!
Did she get a 10?
I'm looking, 9.95, and what's the other judge? And a 10 from the other judge. Oh, so close, 9.975. We'll take it, though. Oh, and I know the gym dogs are relieved right now that Skylar nailed her acro series there. Nice front toss.
I think that's supposed to be a beef jump, I would assume.
I think it was. It wasn't, but small deduction there. Nice switch leap into a split jump. And after what's been a very rough event for the gym dogs, hard to finish strong, and Skylar is doing a really nice job. Oh, and a 1.5 twist out of an aerial. Very difficult dismount.
Yeah, the gym dogs were looking so strong into the final rotation.
And this is usually their best
exactly
event.
Exactly, uncharacteristic for them to have so many falls on beam.
Here is the queen.
And just glancing at the scoreboard here, even before Jade goes, the Beavers are sitting at a 49.45. So This is going to be a huge floor score for the Bees.
She is primed and ready to get a 10 on this event.
Yeah, her teammates have certainly set her up.
Oh,
that double-double. I mean, that is perfection. I don't think you could do a double-double any better.
No, that was just beautiful. She just drops out of the sky. And the rest is really a walk in the park for her.
So effortless.
I mean, elite gymnasts, and especially the reigning Olympic champion, they're used to doing 4 tumbling passes.
Mm-hmm.
And she only has to do 3 now, and so she gets to pick what she wants to do.
Down to this final tumbling pass. Let's see.
Oh,
yes.
That might do it.
I mean, I think Jade deserves a 10. Of course I'm biased.
And Gill is erupting right now.
That was a huge floor rotation.
I don't know. I mean, the Beavers set her up, but
yes.
It was true perfection, in my opinion.
She deserved a 10.
She showed
yes.
Perfect control. There it is.
Ah, hear the crowd roar.
Her second 10.
Oh, my goodness.
Well deserved.
Wow. 2 tens in 1 season for the Beavs and Gill. So exciting. And University of Washington does have a gymnast up performing in the exhibition. But with the lineup change, we are not
We are in
sure.
the dark here. But we are going to watch Jade being congratulated and soaking it in. It really was her best floor performance of the season so far.
You know, and really, it is a big transition to go from elite to college. So in the past, like Heather was saying, yes, Jade had 4 tumbling passes, but she only had to compete those 4 tumbling passes like 4 times a year.
Right.
Now she's done 6 weekends in a row, and it really is like a, I mean, not an all different sport, but quite a few changes that she has just excelled at adapting to.
Yeah, it's a big change having to compete at this level, still a very, very high level every single weekend.
So
and the Beavers posted a 49.675 on floor, which is going to definitely increase their ranking in the country, counting, they dropped a 9.775 and didn't count anything less than a 9.85. So exciting.
And Caitlin Garcia will be performing an exhibition for the Bees.
Nice high.
Very nice double tap from Caitlin. Yeah, this meet as a whole, the Beavs put up several strong exhibition performances. So I'd say that they have the depth in those lineups that they haven't had in years past.
Very true. It's got to be exciting competing after Jade's 10.
Yes.
I mean,
wow.
Well, knowing that your routine is just for you,
uh-huh.
it doesn't matter in the score, so there's no pressure, and so you just get to go out there and have fun.
Yeah. I do wonder, like, what it's like training day to day with someone of the caliber of Dave. Like, how does that impact the atmosphere in the gym? And the, I know we said to the coaches that all the girls are working so hard to make those lineups.
Absolutely. And I can't help but think that it, I mean, as we're seeing in the meets, it is elevating everybody's gymnastics.
Yeah, the season 2022 beats are not the 2021 gymnastics team, that's for sure.
Looks like the final score for the Beavers is a 197-275, so not quite as strong as last weekend, but still a very, very strong score for Oregon State.
And like you said before, the Gym Dogs were looking really good into that final rotation, but unfortunately put up a 47.275 on Bean, so that really hurt their overall score, ending up with a 194.4.